Now, my dear friends, welcome to Attari classes. Today, we have an introductory session onto a technology which is very, very famous in the world by the name vSphere. And vSphere product is from company VMware. I am Maqsood over here. I take trainings at Attari classes for two products. One is vSphere from VMware. And other is AWS Solution Architect Associate Level Training. So I take care of VMware and AWS training at Attari classes. Now, by the way, before going ahead and starting the discussion onto the technology, which is very, 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 very famous in the world by the name VMware vSphere, I will explain you that how this training will go and what is your responsibility and what is the trainer responsibility. Okay. So my dear friend, Please try to understand when you are taking an online training, this training should be an interactive session. It means that whenever you have any doubts or you have any queries, you can ask your doubt and queries so that, my dear friends, while training is going on, you interact live with the trainer, your concepts will get clear. Okay. Raja F says, I am unable to connect in my laptop. No issues. Today you can join from mobile phone because today there is no practicals. Okay. So by the way, you can join from your mobile phone. That is not an issue. But from next lecture, when the practicals will start, next to next lectures, you require a PC or a laptop. For today's lecture, laptop is enough. Mobile phone is also enough because you can install an Android app like on Android or iOS, you can install the GoToMeeting app. Now, what I was saying is that this session should be an interactive session. You can ask your queries and doubts so that live everything is clear. Remember, this training will be hands-on practical training. You will get online labs, everything, where you will be able to do live practicals with the trainer. So remember, there are few online trainings where only trainer will go on explaining everything and the participants will not do anything. They will not do anything. In Attari classes, this is an interactive session with hands-on practical. So remember, whenever trainer will do something, we'll also guide you how to do, and we will make sure that you are also able to do. If you are not able to do some practical, I can take the remote of your system and help you in doing the practical job. You are attending a lecture or the course which we are going to start from today. Today will be the first lecture where we are starting with the first session of this course. Is based on VMware vSphere. Okay, the product is the name of the company is VMware and the product name is vSphere. Few people are saying that they are not able to hear anything. Disconnect and rejoin, and please rejoin using mobile phone if PC sound is not working. Okay. If your PC sound is not working, you can rejoin from mobile phone also. Okay. So my dear friend, make sure that you need to rejoin if you are facing some issues. By the way, everybody should be aware that you have joined this course, and this course is based on vSphere. Remember, vSphere is nothing but the name of the product, and VMware is nothing but name of the company. Like Microsoft is name of the vendor, name of the company, and Windows Server 2K16 or 2K19 is the product. Similar fashion, VMware is name of the company and vSphere is name of the product. Now remember, my dear friends, as today we are starting with the first lecture, everybody should be aware that when we are talking about the product vSphere, which is from the company VMware, this product we are talking vSphere, it is from company VMware. Remember, my dear friend, this product is dedicated for server virtualization. Which virtualization? Server virtualization. So before going ahead and discussing something about vSphere, in today's lecture, when we start with the discussion, I would like to give you a brief idea and basic concept. In detailed discussion we will do related to server virtualization. Okay, so first thing I would like to start is that today I will start and give you a brief idea about what is virtualization of servers.
My dear friend, when you want to virtualize servers, there are two approaches to virtualize servers. One is virtualization management layer approach, and other is dedicated virtualization. First, let's try to understand what is virtualization management layer approach, and then we will be able to discuss what is dedicated virtualization. Okay. So let's discuss first about virtualization management layer approach. My dear friends, hopefully this approach many people have tested in their life, in day-to-day life, for testing, research, development, R&D. Which is this approach? My dear friend, this approach which we are talking in today's session, virtualization management layer approach. What is this approach? Remember, my dear friends, you buy a high-end PC, or in your office you have a high-end desktop machine with, say, for example, 32 GB RAM, or a server with 64 GB RAM. You are already having one operating system like Windows installed onto this. Now, my dear friend, after installing Windows, it will use 4 GB RAM, 6 GB RAM. Are having 32 GB RAM, 64 GB RAM, so you are having memory and CPU free on your hardware. You might be having 32 GB RAM and 8 core of CPU or 16 core CPU. Your machine is using only 8 GB RAM, 4 GB RAM, 6 GB RAM. Now you are having resource free. Now if your operating system is not using the resource, then your resource will be wasted. It means that, my dear friend, what I mean to say is that consider you are having one laptop or desktop with 32 GB RAM and 4 core CPU. You install Windows 10, it is using 4 GB RAM. Your some applications are there, they are using more 4 GB RAM. Total, you are using 8 GB RAM. Your remaining RAM of 20, 24 GB RAM is wasted. Your machine is having 8 core CPU, you are using 10% of CPU, 90% CPU is wasted. Sonali, everybody, Mohammed Sadim, everybody is able to hear clearly now. Yogesh More, everybody is able to hear me clearly, my dear friends. Anybody facing any issues? Sonali is saying that we are not able to hear clearly, my dear sister. Hopefully, possibility that your speaker volume might be down, so please try to increase your speaker volume. Everybody is able to hear me clearly. If somebody is facing issues, it means, my dear friend, there is a problem at your end only. Okay, now, my dear friends, okay, Yogesh More is able to hear me clearly, Prasad Rani is able to hear clearly, that's a good deal. Now, my dear friend, what I mean to say, this 20 24 GB RAM, 90% of CPU is wasted. How to utilize this? There is one concept available over here, is that if your hardware is having more resource, what you can do now on your operating system, that is Windows 10 or Windows 7 or Linux, you can install one virtualization software. What you can do, you know, on your laptop or desktop, you can install virtualization software. Here you can go and install one software which is available from VMware, known as VMware Workstation, which is available for Windows and Linux both. And if your laptop or desktop is having MacBook, Apple Mac, are you aware about Apple MacBooks? Are you aware about the Mac operating system? If you have Windows or Linux, you can install VMware Workstation software. And if you are Apple Mac, there is something known as VMware Fusion. The concept is what, you know, my dear friend? The concept is same, that once you install or create one layer of virtualization, now your laptop is having 20 GB, 22 GB RAM free. You can create one machine, you can create one virtual machine, you can create one virtual machine, you can install Windows, give 8 GB RAM, you can install Linux, give 4 GB RAM, you can install Windows, give 4 GB RAM. You can create multiple virtual machines on your laptop or desktop. Here, this is the approach where on the hardware you have operating system, and on operating system you install Microsoft Virtual PC. There is a software from Microsoft known as Virtual PC. Oracle, there is a software known as VirtualBox, or from VMware, there is a software VMware Workstation. And after installing this, any of this software on your operating system, you can create multiple virtual machines which are virtual, and you can install different server operating system, desktop operating system inside this. Everybody might be aware about this approach. Have you done some testing in on your laptop, desktop in production, right? Those people who are not aware, then today they will become aware that, my dear friend, on hardware you have an operating system, on operating system you install one software. This is nothing but the layer based approach. Why? Because your virtualization software is installed on operating system, which is a general purpose operating system. Windows or Linux or Mac, it is not dedicated, it is a general purpose operating system. If you install Windows, you can install Google Chrome, you can install Microsoft Office, you can install hundreds and thousands of games on Windows. Same for Linux. So remember, when you are using one layer of virtualization on top of your operating system, and using this layer of virtualization, you are creating multiple servers, and this every server, every virtual machine will have one its own OS. Windows, Linux, they will have one application, one application, two application, three. This type of approach where you are installing one layer on top of your operating system is known as management virtualization, management layer. This approach cannot be used in production data centers. Production data centers, this cannot be used. Why? Because consider this is your Windows machine on which you have installed one virtualization software. Everybody knows Windows is very powerful, robust operating system. So robust operating system that if this hardware, if this operating system Windows goes in hang state or not responding state, then there is only one solution. To multiple problems of Windows, there is a single solution. Anybody knows what is that solution? yes, everybody who have worked on Windows domain, they know Windows multiple problem, there is a single solution. If Windows goes in hang state, then my dear friend, there is one simple solution. What is that? Restart. If you restart all your virtual machines which were running on this software, and this software was running on Windows, all the machines will go down. Do you agree? Everything will go down if the machine goes down. Okay, so remember, my dear friend, this approach cannot be used in production data center. Yes, you have a hardware with 64 GB RAM, 32 GB RAM, you install Windows 10, you install virtualization software. One guy is asking one question. What is name? You know, my dear friend, what is the name of that guy? My dear friends, I will announce the name. Let me check the chat. One guy has, Mr. Rajesh Prajapati has asked the question, does it require any license for host operating system? Remember, my dear friend, your host operating system, whenever you are talking about host operating system on the hardware, if you install Windows or Linux, it's obvious that Windows or Linux will require a license, right? If your company is doing proper audits and everything, so it is by default understood that your operating system should have a licensed operating system in production world. So you have a hardware, on top of this you have, say, laptop or desktop, and on top of this you have operating system, and on top of operating system you install virtualization software. This might be a licensed software. If VMware is asking you license, if Microsoft Hyper-V is giving Microsoft Virtual PCs free, then it's free. By the way, you create multiple virtual machines on this. Everything is dependent on this base operating system. If this goes down, everything goes down. That is the reason this approach cannot be used in production data. In production data center, we are not using virtualization management layer approach. Virtualization management layer can be used for testing, research, R&D, development. Why? Because instead of buying 3-4 servers, what you can do, you can create 3 servers on single hardware and you can do the testing. But remember, for production environment, we will go ahead and use dedicated virtualization. What is dedicated virtualization? See over here. This is layer-based approach. This is dedicated virtualization. What is the meaning of dedicated virtualization? On the hardware, no operating system. Directly virtualization software from VMware, that is known as ESXi. Remember, you are joining this course for taking the training on the product vSphere. When the training started, I have informed you vSphere is the product from company VMware. VMware is name of the company, vSphere is product. Whenever you buy vSphere, what do you get? You know, you get this operating system. ESXi is an operating system which is dedicated only for virtualization. That's the reason it is known as hypervisor. So remember, an operating system or a software which is dedicated only for virtualization, it is known as hypervisor. So remember, whenever you buy the product vSphere, you will get ESXi. Now on the hardware, you will not install any operating system. You will directly install virtualization software or hypervisor from VMware, that is ESXi. Now ESXi will be installed bare metal. Bare metal means what? Directly on the hardware, like you install Windows, like you install Linux, you will have a bootable CD or bootable USB drive, and you will directly install ESXi on the hardware. Bare metal means directly on the hardware. Now remember, once you install ESXi directly on the hardware, this is not like Windows, Linux or Mac. This is the operating system which is dedicated only for virtualization. It means, my dear friends, if you install ESXi directly on the hardware, now this is dedicated for virtualization. You can't install Google Chrome browser on this OS. You can't install Microsoft Office on this OS. My dear friends, you can't do anything. What you can do, you know, my dear friend, here you can create virtual machines and you can manage virtual machine. You can configure high availability. You can do load balancing. It means, remember, once you install ESXi, it will allow you to create virtual machines. In production environment, people will install different Windows and different Linux server operating system, application 1, application 2, application 3, database, and multiple things will be installed in this virtual machine, and these are production servers. Okay, so my dear friends, everybody is understanding, we will use dedicated virtualization. It means on hardware, direct virtualization will be installed, no operating system will come, and we will create virtual machine. This is nothing but the approach which is very, very famous into the market, known as dedicated virtualization. Okay, if I talk about dedicated virtualization, my dear friends, you can see in traditional world, in olden days, we used to buy one hardware, we used to install Windows or Linux operating system, and then we used to install application like IIS or something, right? Now on this hardware, you have Windows or Linux, one application. This complete hardware is dedicated only for one OS and one application. Now what we are doing, you know, on this hardware, we are having VMware ESXi. We can create multiple virtual machine. Every virtual machine will have OS and application, OS and application, OS and application. This is nothing but the funda of virtualization. So remember, my dear friend, the complete globe nowadays is using virtualization. अरे द कंप्लीट ग्लोब नाउ व्हाट इज यूजिंग वर्चुअलाइजेशन, व्हाट इज द फंडा ऑन द हार्डवेयर, दे विल हैव हाइपरवाइजर दैट इज नथिंग बट द वर्चुअलाइजेशन सॉफ्टवेयर व्हाट आई सेड ESXi, एंड ऑन टॉप ऑफ दिस यू विल क्रिएट मल्टीपल वर्चुअल मशीन, ईच वर्चुअल मशीन विल हैव दैट ओन ओएस ओन एप्लीकेशन, ओन ओएस ओन एप्लीकेशन, राइट? सो माय डियर फ्रेंड, यस, सोनाली इज आस्किंग अ क्वेश्चन, After installing on the hardware, if on the hardware I will install ESXi, after installing ESXi, can I customize it? Yes, you can customize, you can do security settings, you can change network settings, you can do security settings, multiple things you can do, that everything we will do practically. So my dear friend, what is the meaning of server virtualization? Virtualization is nothing but placing an additional layer of software called as hypervisor on top of your physical server. It means I am having one physical server on my hardware. I will have hypervisor, a virtualization software or operating system like ESXi, which is dedicated for virtualization, is known as hypervisor. Now, what is the benefit of hypervisor, my dear friend? Hypervisor enables you to install multiple operating system and applications on a single server. If you have ESXi, now you create multiple OS, multiple application on a single hardware. Everybody is understanding, my dear friend, what is virtualization? Now, my dear friend, one thing very, very important I want to give you just for the sake of knowledge. Remember, my dear friend, anybody knows who is one of the leading cloud provider in the world? AWS is the number one leading cloud provider in the world. Then after AWS, Azure comes into the picture. Do you agree? Then Google Cloud comes into picture. So these three are the leading cloud provider in the world. Then you have IBM cloud, you have Oracle cloud, you have so many cloud providers in the world. Okay, remember, my dear friend, you go to AWS cloud, you go to Azure cloud, Google cloud, IBM cloud, Oracle cloud. Just for your knowledge, my dear friend, in any cloud you go and you create what? Servers, my dear friend, those servers are nothing but virtual machine. Okay, so are you happy that you have joined the right course, VMware vSphere? So remember, my dear friend, whenever you learn server virtualization, remember all the leading cloud operators in the world are using server virtualization. That's the reason when you go to AWS, the server is known as EC2. When you go to Azure, the server is known as Azure Virtual Machine. So remember, somebody will say virtual private server. Somebody will say dedicated cloud server. Remember, if somebody is saying cloud server, somebody is saying virtual private server, somebody is saying Azure Virtual Machine, somebody is saying EC2. Remember, names are different, but finally, it is actually a virtual machine. So today you come to know that cloud backbone is nothing but virtualization. Have you understood, my dear friend? Okay. And remember, there are big cloud providers in the world who are giving their cloud offering specially on VMware. For example, you go to AWS cloud, they will give you general cloud service. It backend might be VMware, backend might be Hyper-V, backend might be Citrix. Similarly, when you go to Azure, they will give you general cloud service where your backend virtual machine might be on any hypervisor. But remember, if the customer says, I don't want any hypervisor, customer says AWS, Azure, Google Cloud, customer says, my backbone should be VMware. I want vSphere. vSphere means what? vSphere is name of the product. Whenever you buy vSphere, you get which operating system? ESXi. Okay, so remember, if you go to AWS cloud, Azure cloud, Google cloud, and you just specify, I don't want general cloud service, I want my cloud to run on VMware vSphere. It means my server should be running on ESXi. Then I would like to show you something, my dear friends. Everybody can go ahead and just open a Google Chrome browser and just type vmware.com. Please come to vmware.com website. Everybody is on vmware.com website. Please come on to your vmware.com website. If you reach your vmware.com website, please type yes, 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 yes. Now, my dear friends, everybody is on VMware website. Now, my dear friends, after going on VMware website, there is one button, apps and cloud. When you click on apps and cloud, my dear friends, can you, when you go ahead over here, you can go ahead over here and take your mouse cursor on apps and cloud. My dear friends, can you see VMware cloud on AWS, VMware cloud on Dell EMC, Azure VMware solution, Google Cloud VMware solution, IBM Cloud VMware solution, Oracle Cloud VMware solution. It means all the leading top five cloud providers are building their solutions on VMware vSphere. So are you happy? No, only Maksud is not saying that cloud backbone is virtualization and one of the preferred partner used globally for virtualization by the leading cloud vendor is VMware vSphere. Are you happy? What is the role and what is the level of vSphere? Now remember, we are learning virtualization. But in future lectures, I will also explain you something about cloud computing and virtualization, how they are related. In cloud computing, there is one model, infrastructure as a service, software as a service, platform as a service. How cloud is correlated with virtualization. This is not included in syllabus, but Attari classes believes in social work. So remember, Attari Glass's motto is make people happy. When you are learning virtualization, which is the number one virtualization, VMware vSphere has taken 70% market share in the global market of server virtualization. 70% of the server virtualization is done on VMware vSphere. And how these cloud modules are related to virtualization? Everything we will discuss in syllabus, though the cloud computing is not a part of our syllabus, but for around 30 minutes there will be a discussion about cloud computing and virtualization in future lectures. Okay, so now my dear friend, today is the introduction. Today is the first lecture where we have started the introduction to what is server virtualization. I have given you one basic idea what is server virtualization. What is vSphere? Whenever you buy vSphere, you will get ESXi. How to install ESXi? What are the prerequisites for ESXi? Today I will do the practicals, and today itself you will also do some practicals. And remember, from the next lecture, that is tomorrow's lecture, we will do full-fledged practicals also. Today also we will do some practical, and later on also we'll do some practical. Remember, this training is considered as hands-on practical training. Okay, don't worry. We will do many practicals. Now, please pay attention and listen carefully. We have discussed what is server virtualization, but last point is pending. The last point says, my dear friend, many IT and business. Many IT and business benefits are gained from server virtualization. Many IT and business benefits are gained from server virtualization. This is very simple to say, but let me explain you what are the benefits you get from server virtualization. I am giving you one very good example. Everybody is ready with me. Everybody is live with me. Nobody is going in sleep mode. Please type yes, yes, yes in the chat box. If you all are live, you all are listening to me, then please type yes, yes in the chat box. If you type yes, then trainer will become happy. If trainer is happy, then you are also happy. Sabka saath, then sabka vikas. Now, my dear friends, please pay attention and listen carefully. Consider that I am having one data center where all these servers are physical. Okay, all these servers are physical. And how many servers I am having, you know? Assume that we are having 400 servers with 4-core CPU, 4GB RAM, 4-core CPU, 4GB RAM, 4-core CPU, 4GB RAM, 4-core CPU, 4GB RAM, all are physical server. How many? 400 servers. But remember, due to limitation of time and limitation of board, my dear friends, I am drawing only 4 servers. But whenever required, we will multiply by 100 or we will divide by 100. Everybody is understanding the concept. I will give you example of 4 servers, but we will multiply and divide by 100. Everybody is ready for challenge? Remember, when we need to multiply by 100, when we need to divide by 100, I will ask you some question. If you give right answer, it means you are man of the match. Otherwise, you are not man of the match. Okay, now my dear friend, whenever you are having servers in production, I am giving one example. This server is having NIC card teaming done. Or if there is a physical server, do you have double NIC cards teaming done? If one NIC card goes down, your server should not go down. Those people who have worked in data center, they might be aware you have two NIC cards. You might also be aware, my dear friend, on every server you have dual SMPS, dual power supply. Those people who have worked in data center at Dell, HP, IBM servers, right? You have dual power supply. One power supply goes down, your server should not go down. One NIC card goes down, your server should not go down. Consider you are having such 400 servers. Now, my dear friend, I want to give you one example that if your data center is having 400 physical servers, and your company says that now we want to convert these servers into virtual servers on VMware platform, VMware vSphere platform. It means that when you want to convert onto VMware platform, the first and the foremost thing is that you need to buy hardware. Are do you agree? And on hardware, you will install ESXi, right? You will install ESXi. But remember, my dear friend, what should be the configuration of the hardware? How you will come to know? Are how much is the requirement? What? How much RAM? How much CPU is required? How you will come to know? Are my dear friend, when you want to do the conversion from physical to virtual, when you do physical to virtual, it is known as P2V consolidation. What it is known as? Physical to virtual consolidation. Before going for P2V consolidation, my dear friends, what information you should have, you know? Are my dear friend, you should have information about the current resource utilization of your 400 servers. Do you agree? Are you should be aware about the current utilization of RAM and CPU, na? If you are aware how much is current RAM utilized, how much is current CPU utilized in your total 400 servers, then my dear friend, you can buy new hardware and then install ESXi. In your mind, you know, I need to buy one hardware and install ESXi. Now, my dear friend, Kayum is asking, when you buy hardware, there is any recommendation from VMware? Yes, my dear friend, I told you, today we will go ahead and discuss the topic, installation of ESXi. At that time, we will cover what hardware is required, how much RAM is required, how much CPU. That is some different topic, installing ESXi. As of now, we are discussing, Kayum bhai, you want to virtualize 400 server onto VMware platform. The first thing you will require resource utilization. What you will do? For example, you go down and you see the resource utilization of last two quarters, quarter one and quarter two. There are many tools available over there in the market for checking the resource utilization. There are many monitoring tools available from third party. And one of the tool available from VMware is known as VMware Capacity Planning Tool. Okay. So there are many tools available. VMware is own tools available, VMware capacity planning tool. So remember, when you are planning a consultation and the contract is given to vendor, there are many tools available. One of the famous tool is capacity planning tool. Now you will download the performance utilization report from for quarter one and quarter two for this server. Two quarters means 6 months. What is the average use? This is a Windows server. It is using on an average 3 GB RAM and 30% of CPU on an average. In last 6 months, this server is a Linux based server. It is using 1 GB RAM and it is using 10% of CPU. This server is using 2 GB RAM and on an average 25% of CPU. This server is using 1.5 GB RAM and on an average 20% of CPU. Now, my dear friend, you come to know it is using 3 GB, 1 GB, 2 GB, 1.5 GB and 30%, 10%, 25%, 20% CPU. Can anybody tell me 3 GB plus 1 GB is how much? 4. 4 plus 2 is 6.5. 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 plus 1.5 is how much? Total memory requirement is 7.5 GB RAM, which is utilized. Okay. And my dear friend, total CPU utilizes 30% plus 10% plus 25% plus 20%. Before going ahead with CPU calculation, I will try to create one chart over here. Provisioned and utilized, RAM and CPU. Pay attention. Provision RAM, 4 GB plus 4 GB plus 4 GB plus 4 GB. How much is the provision RAM? Array, total RAM available in physical server is how much? 16 GB RAM. Amit Singh is man of the match. Right answer. 16 GB RAM is provisioned. 4 core CPU plus 4 core plus 4 core plus 4 core. How much cores are available in CPU? 16 cores of CPUs are provisioned on your hardware. Now, my dear friend, when you are checking the utilization, you found that the utilization of RAM is 7.5 GB RAM. Okay. But can anybody tell me CPU? 30% plus 10, 40, 40 plus 25, 65, 65 plus 20, 85. Giving a bonus of 15% to make our example simple. If your CPU utilization, you give bonus 15%, 85 plus 15 will come to 100%. So CPU utilizes 100%. It means how many cores? Can anybody tell me how many cores? My dear friends. Okay, Sachin Patil, Swapnil Jagtap, everybody Akshay, everybody is wrong. Only one guy is right. That is Sushil Parmar, man of the match. Are 4 cores. Are my dear friend, 4 cores. Why? You are doing the percentage calculation over year 30, 10, 25, 20. On what? Are you are doing calculation based on 4 cores, na? Okay, so everybody has understood. Sushil Parmar is a very good, intelligent guy. He is able to answer. That's the reason I told you. Everybody is live with me. Nobody is sleeping. I will ask you one question. And now I have asked you one question. Only one guy has given right answer. Avinash Bhai says, I have not understood. Pankaj Singh says, I have also not understood. No tension, my dear friend. You are in Attari classes. Trainer will explain you again. See, my dear friend, when I told you 30% of CPU, then it is on 4 core. When I say 10% of CPU, it is on 4 core. 25% on CPU, it is on 4 core. 20% of CPU, it is on 4 core. The total combination is 85% plus 15% I gave bonus. So it is 100%. 100% means what? Are I am doing calculation on 4 core, na? Getting the point, Akshay Bhai, Pankaj Singh, Avinash Singh. So my dear friend, we have done calculation of this percentage. So actual utilize is 4 core CPU and 7.5 GB RAM. Now you are aware. You were aware. Yes, Akshay Bhai is saying primary mathematics. Remember, in Attari classes, you learn mathematics also. Array, you learn what is cloud computing also. It means, remember, if you join Attari class course and you learn VMware, array, after learning VMware, you can participate in technical Kaun Banega Crorepati KBC also, and you might get 1 crore. Okay, so my dear friend, don't take tension. Attari classes will make your life simple. Now, my dear friend, Pankaj Singh is saying, Sachme sir, okay, if there is a technical KBC, then you can participate. Now, my dear friend, please pay attention. When you have a hardware, you will install ESXi, but on this hardware, now you will not put 16 GB RAM. You will not put 16 core CPU. Your requirement is only 7.5 GB RAM. So you will put 12 GB RAM. Your requirement is only 4 core CPU. So you will not put 16 core CPU. You will put 8 core CPU. What you will do, you know, there is one software which can convert your physical servers to virtual. That's the software is known as P2V converter. I will show you this practical, how to do P2V, how to install P2V converter, everything in last lecture. Okay, so don't worry. As of now, assume that there is one software which is available. The name is P2V converter. What it will do, you know, it will convert your server as it is physical to virtual machine. Whatever OS and application was installed in this hardware, everything remains same. Now these physical servers are now virtual machine. As per the calculation of last two quarter one and quarter two, the utilization of RAM was 7.5 GB. So consider if the RAM utilization is 7.5 GB, still I am having 4.5 GB RAM free. I am having 4.5 GB RAM free. Considering that in the last two quarters, the CPU utilization was 4 cores. This is 4 cores. The CPU utilization is 4 cores. Consider 7.5 GB RAM. CPU utilization is 4 cores. So consider if the CPU utilization was 4 core, it remains same. I am having 4 core CPU free. Are you getting the point? So remember, my dear friend, instead of having 16 GB RAM, I have used only 12 GB RAM. So how much I have saved on RAM? 25%. Array, 25% I have saved on RAM now. And my dear friend, instead of having 16 cores of CPU, I am having only 8 cores of CPU. So I have saved 50% on CPU. Array, do you agree? After saving 25% on RAM and 50% on CPU, my dear friend, I am having still 4.5 GB RAM free and still 4 core of CPU free. So remember, what is the benefit of virtualization? I am saving memory. I am saving CPU. And even after saving 25% RAM, 50% of CPU, my dear friend, even after doing the saving, I am able to get more resource free. Now tell me, my dear friend, if I am having total utilization in 400 servers. I am talking about 400 servers, right? This was the example I gave as a layman example I gave you of 4 servers, and we are multiplying by 400 servers. Consider, my dear friend, in production environment, if you have 400 servers physical and you will save 25% on RAM and 50% on CPU, is this a huge saving? Is this a huge saving, my dear friends? Okay, so remember, my dear friends, you will save crores of rupees on your infrastructure. If consider somewhere the 10 TB RAM is used and after virtualization of servers only 6 TB RAM is required, you will save 40% on RAM also. Now, my dear friend, this is the small saving, big saving, large saving on CPU and memory. I have told you that all the servers are having 2 NIC cards. Okay, these are physical servers, not virtual machines as of now. Tell me, if you are having 400 servers, each server having 2 NIC cards, so total how many NIC cards you require? 800 NIC cards. And if you have 800 NIC cards, 800 server, these all NIC cards are connected to one particular physical switch. They are connected to switch. So if I am having 800 NIC card, how many ports on switch I will require? I will require 800 ports or 400 ports, 800 ports. And I will require 800 cables also. I will require 800 cables also, 800 NIC card, 800 ports, 800 cables. In one batch, one guy has answered that 800 NIC cards are required, but only 400 ports will be required and 400 cables will be required. Why? 400 cables Wi-Fi. my dear friend, he had done a mistake in calculation. We cannot have a Wi-Fi communication in data center. my dear friend, 400 servers, every server having 2 NIC cards. So you have 800 NIC cards, 800 ports on the switch. My dear friend, so to virtualize 400 servers, if you have physical 400 servers, you require 800 NIC cards, 800 cables, and 800 ports on switch. Now, one switch is of 32 port Cisco switch. Then you will require 27 switch. To have 800 ports, you require 32. You have 32 ports on a single switch. So approximate, you will require 27 switch. Now one Cisco switch with 32 port is coming a few lakhs, but I am giving Attari class discounted rate of 1 lakh. actual cost might be very high, 2-3 lakhs, 2.5 lakhs, but I am giving you a discounted rate of Attari class is 1 lakh. Now, if even the switch cost is 1 lakh, yes, NIC card means LAN card. Yes, Moria, Mr. Moria, you are right. NIC card means LAN card. Now, my dear friend, 1 lakh, Cisco switch is costing 1 lakh. Now, my dear friend, if you buy 27 switch, it will cost you 27 lakhs. Can you understand the difference, right? This is only switch purchase cost. I have not considered the cable cost and NIC card cost. But remember, my dear friends, try to understand. If I am having one hardware, I will install ESXi operating system, that is hypervisor, on this hardware. I am having consider 96 GB RAM on this hardware. Can I virtualize 20 virtual machine on this hardware? Can I convert physical 20 server to virtual machine? Can I convert 20 physical servers to virtual machines? My dear friends, remember, whenever I install ESXi host, in ESXi host, one switch is created by default, that is known as virtual switch. Which switch? Virtual switch. Whenever you install ESXi, one virtual switch is created and all the virtual machines are connected to this switch. are you understanding? So my dear friends, I will try you to show one snapshot over here. Can you see over here? This is inside ESX host. One switch is created and all your virtual machines are connected to this switch, that is virtual switch. So now, my dear friend, everybody is understanding, if I am having on one ESX host 20 virtual machines, how many virtual machines? 20 virtual machines. Total, I am having how many physical server? I am having total 400 physical server. Do you agree? I am giving the example of 400 physical server. On one hardware, I have installed ESX with 96 GB RAM. So I can convert 4444 GB RAM 20 server. Now tell me, if one hardware I am having 20 virtual machines, so for 400 physical server, how many ESX server I will require? How many ESX I will require? I will require multiple ESX server, right? This is my one ESX server where there are 20 server virtualized. Second ESX 20 virtualized. Third ESX 20 virtualized. So search 20, 20, 20, I will require 1, 2, 3, 4, how many servers? 20 ESX servers. Swapnil Jagtap, your calculation is wrong. You are saying 200. Either it was a spelling mistake or either it was a typing mistake. And Abhijit is giving the answer 400. Are my dear friends, everybody is in cloud or everybody is in Atari class. Are what I'm trying to explain you, my dear friend, please try to understand. You are having 400 physical servers, right? 400 physical servers. You have converted 20 servers as virtual machine on one ESX server. So second ESX also you will convert 20, third also you will convert 20. So to convert 400 servers, you will require 20 ESX server. Do you agree? Everybody agrees you will require 20 ESX. So 20 into 20 will give you 400. Now, my dear friends, please pay attention. ESX server is having memory, 96 GB RAM, right? This ESX hardware where you have installed ESX, this is known as host. Host means it is having resource. And remember these virtual machines what you have created, nah? These are known as guest. Why? Because these virtual machines are using memory and CPU. So the machine which is supplying memory and CPU, ESX, is known as host. And the machine which are using memory and CPU are known as guest. So my dear friend, making things very simple, you have 400 physical server and you have one ESX host. Inside that ESX host, you have multiple virtual machine. In our example, we are saying 20 virtual machine. There is ESX installed over here. And now this 20 virtual machines are there on one ESX. So 20 virtual machine will get virtual network card, virtual networking on vSwitch. Do you agree? They will get free of charge networking on virtual switch. Now that is software switch. But remember, this ESX server is a hardware, na? It's a hardware, na? Dell, HP, IBM hardware, right? So on this ESX server, you need to put NIC card. How many NIC cards you will put on one hardware? One hardware you will put how many NIC cards? Teaming should be done. Two NIC cards. But remember, recommended you will put 4 NIC cards. Why? You will understand in networking lecture why 4 NIC cards are recommended on ESX server. You will have 1, 2, 3, 4 NIC cards on one ESX server. All virtual machines are connected where? They are connected to virtual switch. But this ESX server is installed on the physical hardware. This physical hardware is 4 NIC card. 4 NIC card cables will go, 4 LAN card cable will go to the physical switch. Do you agree? Why 4 NIC card? You will understand in networking lecture. Because in networking, there is different types of traffic. vMotion traffic, fault tolerance traffic. You will understand later on. So remember, you will require 4 NIC card on one ESX hardware. Now you are having total to virtualize 400 physical server. In the previous example we have discussed, you will require 20 ESX server. One ESX server, 20 virtual machine. So 20 ESX, you will have 400 machine. And each ESX is having only 4 NIC card. So 20 ESX will have how many NIC card? 20 ESX will require how many NIC card? 20 ESX will require 80 NIC card. 80 cables and 80 ports. Do you agree? 80 NIC card, 80 cable and 80 ports. So remember, my dear friend, if your servers are physical, every server require 2 NIC card, you require 800 ports, 800 cables and 800 NIC card. If you virtualize on VMware platform, it is drastically coming to 80 ports, 80 cables, 80 NIC cards. So cost saving is how much percent? Array from 800 to 80, the cost saving on networking is 90%. Are you understanding, my dear friend? Are you understanding, my dear friend, why everybody is going towards server virtualization? When you virtualize server, remember your server is not a physical server now. Your server becomes a virtual machine on ESX. This virtual machine gets a free networking on virtual switch. Only your ESX server will connect to physical switch. So instead of 800, you require only 80. So you are using, my dear friends, 90% saving on networking when you talk about server virtualization, your network infrastructure cost is also reduced. Avinash Bhai saying there is no drawback in virtualization compared to physical server. Avinash Bhai, remember we are learning server virtualization. You have joined the course of server virtualization. We have started with introduction of virtualization and we have already discussed dedicated virtualization approach is the number one approach used in data center, used in AWS cloud, Azure cloud, Google cloud. Everybody is having benefit. What are the disadvantages, my dear friend? You get benefit, benefit, benefit only. Everybody is understanding, my dear friend. Instead of one hardware, on one hardware, you are having multiple virtual machines. Now, my dear friend, what other benefits you are getting, you know? Are we are yet discussing only on one point. Many IT and business benefits are gained. One benefit is RAM and CPU. Other benefit is networking. Now, my dear friend, quickly going ahead. If you have 400 server, each server having two power supply, then 400 into two power supply, you will require how many power supply? 800. But consider you are having 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. You have only 20 ESX server. Each ESX server, you have 20 virtual machines. Okay. Now, each ESX server, you will have only two power supply. Are you will not say, I want four power supply and different types of power. Are in network card, you have different types of network traffic. But power supply SMPS, only two is enough on ESX server. Are on Dell, HP, IBM hardware, two power supplies are enough. So remember, if you have 20 ESX, two power supply, you will require only 40 power supply. Here you require 800. So how much cost you will save on power? How much cost you will save on power from 800 to 40? 95%. Rajesh, Mayur, Hemant, mathematics is very good. You are in sync with trainer. Now, my dear friend, please, please, please try to understand 800 power supply to 40. How much power you are saving, networking you are saving, RAM and CPU are saving. If you will save on power, will you save on cooling also? Are will you save on cooling? And remember, my dear friend, other one big thing you will save. Can anybody tell me? Now I will not give the answer. I want answer from you. What other things you will save? The big thing you will save. Yes, that is very, very important is, my dear friend, space. Mohammed Sadeem, Sonali, Amol Sakmal, Amol Sorar, Jake Furtado, everybody is there. Matin Kaskar Bhai, Sachin Patel, Sonali, Sudhan Gume, Swapnil Jagtap, Yogesh More, everybody is there with me listening. Okay, my dear friends, everybody is able to listen carefully, then trainer is also happy. Now, my dear friend, don't go in sleep mode. Very important lecture. My dear friend, space is very important. Can you just imagine if you want to keep 400 servers in one data center, how much space you will require, how much racks you will require, and to keep 20 ESX server, how much space you will require? Are, can you understand, my dear friend? So 400 servers keeping how much space required and 20 ESX you require 20, 2 racks, 3 racks, 400 server you will require 40 to 50 racks. So remember, my dear friend, here you require a huge space, here you require a small space, 2 racks or 3 racks are more than enough. So remember, my dear friend, you will save crores of rupees on space also, power also, cooling also. That is the reason the complete world is going towards virtualization of server. Many IT and business benefits are gained from server virtualization. So everybody has understood what is the benefit of server virtualization. I have given you several examples. What are the benefit of server virtualization? Now, my dear friend, see things available on the PPT before VMware. You have one server, another. Now, my dear friend, your servers are only 2 or 3 and everything is virtual. So remember, my dear friend, what you are saving. Consider, my dear friends, you are having 10 physical servers and each server is costing $4,000. You pay $40,000. If now 3 physical servers are costing you $4,000, you pay $12,000. So you pay 70% cost, $28,000, you save. So remember, virtualization is doing what? On same one single hardware, you have virtualization and you create multiple virtual machines. So this is your CapEx. CapEx is nothing but your investment cost, capital expenditure. When you create a new application, new server, how much you will save on the CapEx. OpEx is operational cost. When CapEx is saved, instead of 10 server, you buy only 3. So your expenses, your maintenance cost will be also with 3. So remember, if you invest less, you do maintenance less. Now, my dear friend, another benefit of virtualization is that what you know, on one ESX server, you create one virtual machine. Now you want to make this server down due to some reason, or on this server memory is less, CPU is less, but this server memory and CPU is more. What you can do now? You can live migrate your server from one hardware to another hardware using the technology known as vMotion. So remember, if this is the hardware, my dear friend, and this hardware is having, for example, 256 GB RAM, and this hardware is having 512 GB RAM, this might be an old model, this might be a new model, hardware independence. You can migrate your virtual machine to any similar or different physical server also. You can live migrate your application from one hardware to another hardware without any downtime. This is possible. Why? Because virtual machine is not running on hardware. Virtual machine is running on ESXi. Here also there is what? ESXi. So from this ESX server to this ESX server, you can live transfer the machine without any dependency on your hardware. So everybody has understood what is server virtualization, what are the benefits. Now take an example. If there is a physical server, take an example where there is a physical server. In the physical server, my dear friend, if there is a disaster recovery plan, what happens if this physical server goes down? You need to have a new hardware, install your OS, configure your OS, install your backup agent, and then you will be able to restore. It takes 3 hours, 4 hours, 10 hours, 5 hours time. But remember, in virtual, you have the virtual ESX server, 3 virtual machine running. This ESX server goes down. You have taken the backup. Nothing to do on this ESX, just restore. Within 10 minutes, all will be up. If this server is a Dell server, this server is an HP server, no issue. The backend of both is ESX, ESX. So in olden days, when you have one physical server, it goes down. Now bring new hardware, install OS 30 minutes, configure OS, application 45 minutes, then install the backup agent, then restore. It takes 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours. So remember, now your virtual machine, all the backups are available. Just go ahead and restore on any ESX, it will work. You can restore on any ESX. Rohit bhai, the same ESX. Remember, if this ESX is down, you can restore on any another ESX. Everybody is able to understand, my dear friend, how if your server is virtual, disaster recovery takes 3 hours, 4 hours. Now it will take only 10, 15 minutes. ESXi version can be also different. Okay, now you can restore on a different version of ESXi also. Okay, not an issue. Everything we'll discuss, which versions are compatible, which are not compatible. Okay, now my dear friend, Avinash is saying, can we migrate ESXi to any other virtualization like Citrix, Microsoft? Just to know, my dear friend, ESX to ESX vMotion will work. Okay, okay, my dear friend, ESX to ESX vMotion will work. Sonali is saying P2B. As of now, we are discussing P2V. Sonali, okay, P2V topic will come. At that time, we will discuss what is P2V, V2V, V2P, multiple things. We will have a discussion. Don't worry. Okay, as of now, concentrate on server virtualization. Now, what is network virtualization? My dear friend, network virtualization will provide what? Network functionality in software. What is the meaning of this? My dear friend, try to understand. Try to understand. If you have a laptop or a desktop, and on top of this, you install Windows 10, and you install VMware workstation software, you create multiple virtual machines. Are you able to ping multiple virtual machines? If you have VMware workstation or Microsoft virtual PC, and you prepare a home lab, are you able to ping multiple virtual machines? Yes. all virtual machines are having virtual NIC card, virtual NIC card, virtual NIC card, virtual NIC card. Do you agree? Are whenever you go to virtual machine, you need to give the IP address. Now they are also having NIC card. But remember, these virtual NIC card are connected where? Are virtual NIC card in the backend are connected to virtual switch. Okay. So remember, like physical server, you are connecting to physical switch. Now virtual machines are connected to virtual switch. Are functionality is same na? One server communicating with another, communicating with another, communicating other. But instead of buying a physical hardware, you are getting same functionality in a virtual switch. When we are talking about VMware, see over here, my dear friend, as soon as you install ESX, na, once you install ESX and you log into ESX and you will check, you will find one virtual switch is automatically created on ESX. Whenever you create virtual machine, na, all virtual machines are connected to virtual switch. So virtual machines are connected to virtual switch. So my dear friend, this virtual switch is acting like a physical switch. It is allowing you to communicate between two virtual machines, right? So remember, my dear friend, what is network virtualization? It provides network functionality in a software. Instead of hardware, you don't need to buy hardware. You get a virtual switch inside ESX. What is the benefit? Array benefit is that your 20 virtual machines are connected to virtual switch. So no save, no cost, no space required, no power required, nothing. Array network virtualization, I told you, 800 network cards, 800 ports on the switch. It will be reduced to 80 ports. Why? Remember, my dear friend, how it will reduce? See over here. You will have one ESX server with 20 virtual machines. They will get free networking on vSwitch, but this ESX server will require few NIC cards to connect to physical switch. Array, do you agree? Array, it will connect to physical switch. Nah? So here you require only 4 NIC cards. You don't require 2 NIC cards for every virtual machine. They are getting free virtual switch connectivity. So remember, when you are using virtual networking of vSphere, you save power, cost, cooling, everything. Okay. Yes, Amit Singh is asking, different physical hardware vendor of ESX can work? Yes, it can work, but there are some criteria how to work and what to will work, what not will work. We will discuss those things also later on when we discuss high availability and load balancing. So network virtualization is so simple. Instead of using a physical network device, you are using a virtual switch which provides same network functionality in a software. Now, my dear friends, what is storage virtualization? Remember, storage virtualization is what you know. It removes the physical mapping of storage and moves the storage in logical objects. It will remove the physical mapping of storage and convert into logical objects. What do you mean by this? Array, my dear friend, I will give you one example, then you will understand. Examples are very important in life. Do you agree? Array, examples are very important in life. Do you agree, my dear friend? Without example, nothing will work. Okay, now, my dear friend, please try to pay attention and listen carefully. Nowadays, everybody is working from home. But remember, before COVID also, many people were working from home. Array, they used to be on Saturday, Sunday, weekend calls. Then company will give one laptop to you. And in emergency, you will log in from your home and you will do the task. My dear sister Sonali is asking one question. Virtual machine network is different and physical switch is different. See, Sonali, my dear sister, you are in confused mode. Please come out of the confused mode. See, try to understand. I am having one Dell server. I am having 512 GB RAM and I am having a 32 core CPU. Okay. On this Dell hardware, I will install ESXi. I will create multiple virtual machines, multiple virtual machines. All virtual machines will be connected to virtual switch. Do you agree this much? Array, virtual machine hai, virtual NIC card na, they will be connected to virtual switch. But remember, this ESX server will have physical NIC card. Array, this is the physical hardware, na? Dell IVM hardware, like laptop, we have, desktop, we have. this hardware will have NIC card which will be connected to physical switch. Okay, Sonali. So remember, ESX server will have physical NIC card which will connect to physical switch. Virtual machine will never connect directly to physical switch. Are virtual machines are virtual? Can you put cable in a virtual switch? My dear sister Sonali, can you put cable in virtual machines? Are can you put cable in virtual machine? Can you put cable in virtual switch? Nothing. So remember, my dear friend, everybody has understood. Sonali, your concept is clear. Okay, it's virtual only. Virtual machine, card is virtual, and cables are virtual, switch is also virtual. ESX server is a physical hardware, so ESX server will have physical NIC card. Now, my dear friends, please pay attention over here and listen carefully. We were discussing one topic that you are having a laptop given by your company for some official purpose, and you have got this laptop. Nowadays, when earlier also when people used to get a laptop from office, and people are using laptop sometimes for office work, some call or some urgent task they are using. Nowadays people are using more work from home, otherwise people were occasionally using office laptop. But now your laptop is having high-end configuration, 32 GB RAM, 8-core CPU. You are very happy. What do? You tell your kids to play game on laptop. You tell people to do surfing. All your family members are checking email, Gmail, Yahoo mail from this official laptop. When you are doing office work, you are using for office work. When you are not using, then your family members are using this laptop for different purpose. Now your boss calls and says, my dear engineer, you need to travel to one location for some project related task for 1 week, 7 days. There is a customer available over there. You need to go and do the meeting with customer. Consider from Mumbai, you need to travel to Bangalore or Chennai or Hyderabad. He will say, these are the tickets I booked for you. This is the hotel I booked for you, and you need to travel today evening. Now, my dear friend, you come to your home, and for sure you will close the laptop lid and take the laptop in your bag to Bangalore because you are going for an office project. But as soon as you are trying to close the laptop lid, your family members are coming and asking. One family member is known as Home Minister. She will come and say, my dear husband, where are you taking this laptop? You will say, this laptop needs to be taken to Bangalore because I am going for a project work for 7 days. All my office data applications are installed in this laptop. I require this laptop. What she will say, then how our kids will play the game? If they don't play the game, they will not take proper food. How I will check the emails? Now what answer you will give? Are you will tell, please understand, I am going for an official task to Bangalore. I need to take this laptop. But whatever means you try to convince, your family will become unhappy because you are taking laptop. Do you agree? Now, my dear friend, family becomes unhappy. Consider you don't take laptop, then office task becomes unhappy. Then office will become unhappy if you don't take the laptop. Now, my dear friend, if you don't take laptop, there is a problem. If you take laptop, there is a problem. What to do? Don't worry. You have joined Attari classes. What you can do, you know? Attari classes will teach you how to take laptop. How to take laptop to Bangalore without taking the laptop. Are my dear friend, what you might be thinking, are what Maksud you are speaking, are you there with on the right path? Are take laptop without taking the laptop, how it can be done? You know, my dear friend, what I will do, you know, I will connect one USB hard disk onto this laptop. I will install P2V converter software on this laptop, P2V converter software. When I will start P2V conversion software on this laptop, it will ask me, you want to convert what? I will say, I want to convert local machine. It will ask where you want to convert. You will say, I want to convert into this USB disk. After 1 hour or 2 hour, it will create one VMDK file. Whatever hard disk was available with OS application, everything installed will be converted into VMDK file. Remember, VMDK file is virtual machine hard disk file. Like PowerPoint is having extension .ppt, document is having extension .doc, Excel is having extension .xls. Virtual machine hard disk is having extension VMDK. If your this hard disk size data available in the hard disk was 100 GB, and by doing P2V, you can make the size as 100 GB or 120 GB or 150 GB. You can change the size also when you do P2V. I will show you later on when we do the P2V practical. Plus, it will create one small file, which is this is GB file, GB's file, depending upon the data of your operating system. And this is a VMX file. This is nothing but a configuration file of 3 to 4 KB. What is this file? Which operating system? What is the MAC address of your virtual machine? How many NIC cards are given? This is the configuration file. You will get VMX and VMDK file in your USB hard disk. After your P2V is completed, what you will do now? You will remove these hard disks from laptop. And you will tell your family members, please use this laptop. I don't need this laptop. You will take this USB hard disk to Bangalore. In Bangalore, customer will give you one PC. On that PC, you will attach this hard disk. And on VMware website, there is one free software available known as VMware Player. VM Player software. What is this? No, it can play virtual machine. It is a free software. It cannot play audio video file. It can play virtual machine. If you install virtual machine player on Bangalore PC, you connect your hard disk. In your hard disk, you have VMDK and VMX file. When you want to play the virtual machine, you will give the path of your virtual machine configuration file, VMDK file. Now your laptop will play as a virtual machine. Same Windows 10, all application, all data, all software, as it is same, it will work as a virtual machine. So are you happy now? Without taking laptop, you have taken laptop to Bangalore? Okay, so remember, my dear friend, this is nothing but storage virtualization. What is storage virtualization? It will remove the physical mapping of storage. Your hard disk is there in laptop. It has a mapping with the hardware. It will remove and move into logical objects. Are, what is this logical object? This logical or virtual object is a VMDK file. It can be easily managed. Take an example. See over here graphics. See the graphics so carefully. Are, this was your physical server with OS application, so many installed. You install P2V converter and convert into virtual machine. Your app OS, application operating system, everything, entire state of the virtual machine is a set of file, VMDK file, VMX file, configuration file. You can move and copy your virtual machine easily. Now you take your machine, copy, put your machine in USB hard disk and take to Bangalore. Everybody is happy, my dear friend. So consider your friend birthday is going to come. And you will promise your friend, I will give you laptop on your birthday. Are, when birthday date will come, which laptop you will give? Are, you will give 32 GB pen drive. And in that pen drive, you will do conversion P2V of your laptop. And you will give the pen drive. He will ask, "Are, where is the laptop?" You will say, "My dear friend, I have promised you to give laptop, but you don't know. I am a student of Attari classes. I am giving you virtual laptop." You need to connect this 32 GB pen drive in your home PC, and once you power on my laptop, you will be able to find one virtual machine that is nothing but my virtual laptop. Okay, so everybody is understanding what is storage virtualization. You convert your servers into a VMDK file. Many benefits are achieved from virtualization. One benefit is lower cost of storage. Consider your laptop was having SSD disks, but you are converting P2V. It is a normal hard disk, no tension. Ease of data migration. In olden days, when I was working in 2006 in Reliance Data Center, Tata Technopolis, if one customer wants to move, if we want to move one customer from Nashik to Mumbai, there was a planning phase. Should we move the server? Other guy will say, no, let's take the backup of server and bring the tape in Mumbai, and then we will restore the backup in Mumbai server. Nowadays, it is so easy. If you want to take your server from US also to India, you just copy the VMDK file and VMX file, and your server is migrated to Mumbai. Okay, and your administrative burden of carrying the servers, putting in tempo, overloading, loading, unloading, everything has been reduced. So now everybody is understanding, my dear friends, what is storage virtualization. It will remove the physical mapping and move into a VMDK file or a configuration file, VMX file. In short, I want to explain you something very, very important, my dear friends. Please try to listen carefully. Very, very important thing. We are talking about server virtualization. You are having one physical server. This is your physical server. It is having a physical network card, NIC card, LAN card. Do you agree? It has a physical hard disk inside this. Do you agree? But remember, my dear friend, when you start server virtualization, you have one ESX server. On that ESX server, you convert this physical server to virtual machine. This is nothing but server virtualization. But when virtual machines become virtual, it is having one NIC card that is also virtual. So your NIC card network also becomes virtual, and virtual machine is having one VMDK file. It means hard disk also becomes virtual. Are, do you agree? Everything is virtual, 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 virtual. Are you getting the point? So remember, very important, when you learn server virtualization, server virtualization will happen only if network and storage is also virtualized. So remember, when you learn server virtualization, network virtualization, storage virtualization automatically becomes a part of server virtualization. You are learning which product? You are learning vSphere from VMware for virtualizing server. So when you learn vSphere server virtualization, you need to learn vSphere network virtualization. You need to learn vSphere storage virtualization also. That's the reason, my dear friend, to make you understand vSphere network virtualization, we have 6-hour session. 2 hours, 2 hours, one session, 4 hours, and another 2-hour session. 6-hour session we have only on network virtualization standard switch. And another one session we have on distributed switch. There are two types of switch in VMware. One is standard, other is distributed. So we will learn vSphere. We will learn server virtualization. Remember, my dear friends, we will learn network virtualization. We will learn storage virtualization also with respect to vSphere. Are you happy? Okay, my dear friends, just see over here. I will go ahead and show you attariclasses.in VMware. When I go ahead over here on VMware, can you see this link is available? I am giving you on chat box also. This is nothing but VMware vSphere syllabus. Okay, we are here on server storage network virtualization. We go ahead, we do many things. And after that, we do, my dear friend, multiple things related to networking. Then comes a part of storage. Can you see? This is the complete syllabus available over here. Can you see? So many things we need to do. P2P conversion is there. Distributed switch is there. So my dear friend, what I mean to say that whenever you learn server virtualization, storage and network virtualization becomes the part of VMware vSphere. Everybody, concept is clear? Clearly, that what you are going to learn in this syllabus, you are going to create wonders in your life. Now, I want to give you one more idea. Please try to pay attention. If you have a Windows physical server and you have a hard disk attached, which format you will format it? A Windows server, when you have a hard disk attached, which format you will format? You will format in NTFS format. if you have a Linux machine and you have an hard disk attached, which format you will format? Array, you will format in ext, any version 3.4, whatever it is. Remember, my dear friend, Windows has its own file system, Linux is having its own file system. Do you agree? Now try to understand very important concepts. When you have ESX server, you have one hardware, you install ESXi. Consider this hardware is having 1 TB hard disk. Which TB hard disk? 1 TB hard disk. Remember, this complete hard disk of 1 TB, which is available, 1 TB hard disk, which is available, will be formatted in VMFS version 6. Which version? 6. Remember, we are talking now about the latest version of VMware ESXi 7, which was introduced in April 2020, ESXi 7. Where whenever you will format the hard disk, the version is VMFS 6. Remember, if you have ESX 6.5, if you have ESX 6.7, then also your file system is VMFS version is 6. Okay, so remember, if this is 6.5, 6.7, version is 6. Yes, if you have ESX I 6, that is vSphere 6, then the version was VMFS 5. Okay, till version vSphere 6, version was VMFS 5. But since ESX version vSphere 6.5, vSphere 6.5, and vSphere 6.7, and ESX I 7, the VMFS version is 6. Array, why I am giving you all the details, you know, because I am taking VMware training since version 4. I have trained approximately 5,000 students on VMware and AWS. If you go in interview, this class task is not only, this class is not only to give an idea about the current version. I will always try to give you the updates, what was old, what was new. Remember, VMFS version 6 and VMFS version 6 came since 6.5, 6.7. So if you go in interview, somebody will ask, we are having 6.5. What is the version of VMFS? 6. If somebody says we are using vSphere 6, then what is the version of file system? It was VMFS 5. Okay. Now, my dear friends, in VMFS 5 and VMFS 6, what is the difference? Somebody is asking. A better performance is always available in a newer version. Okay. So a better performance is always available in newer version. But by default, VMFS is now available is VMFS version 6. Now, try to understand, my dear friend, one thing very basic. Everybody, concepts are clear. What do you mean by VMFS? VMFS is a file system of ESXi. Now, you are having 1 TB hard disk, and this complete 1 TB hard disk is formatted as VMFS 6. By default, which who will format? ESX will format in VMFS 6. Now, you will create one virtual machine, and you will install, when you want to install Windows 2K19, you will give a 50 GB hard disk. That 50 GB VMDK file will be created on VMFS storage. Do you agree? Do you agree? If you create a new machine with Linux and you give 20 GB hard disk, that 20 GB VMDK file will be created over here. You create one more Windows machine and you give, my dear friends, 80 GB hard disk, this 80 GB VMDK file will be created over here. Do you agree? So remember, my dear friend, whenever you create a virtual machine, Windows, Linux, Windows, whenever you try to create any virtual machine, it will ask you which data store you want to put. Remember, the storage which is connected to your ESX host. Please pay attention. Repeating again, the storage which is connected to ESX is known as data store. If you have a Windows machine, you connect a USB hard drive, you connect a internal hard disk, you say C drive, D drive, F drive. Array, in Windows we say drive, na? Array, C drive, D drive, E drive, F drive. Do you agree? So remember, whatever storage connected on Windows machine or Linux machine, it is known as drive. But remember, in VMware, we don't say drive. Remember, whatever storage connected to ESX instead of drive, a technical term is known as data store. So this storage, which is connected to ESX host and formatted as VMFS, it is known as data store. Everybody concept is clear. What is data store? Data store is a storage attached to ESX host and used by ESX host. So whenever you will create any virtual machine and you want to put this hard disk 50 GB, 20 GB, 80 GB, you will put where? You will put on the storage of ESX host. That is known as data store. So consider here you are having 1 TB space. How much TB space? 1 TB space. You have created one hard disk of 50, another hard disk of 20, and another hard disk of 80. So how much GB space you have occupied? Array 50 plus 20, 70 plus 80, how much GB space you have occupied? Array 150 GB space you have occupied. But remember, if you log into this Windows server after installing OS, you have given 80 GB. It has created one file of 80 GB. This has created one file of 20 GB. This has created one file of 50 GB. But when you log into Windows, will C drive use 80 GB after installation? Will Linux drive will use 20 GB after installation? Will this Windows drive will use 50 GB after installation? No. This might use 15 GB. This is a Linux server. It might use only 5 GB. And this is a Windows server. It might again use 10 GB. So remember, actual utilize is 10 GB. Actual utilize is 5 GB. Actual utilize is 15 GB. So total actual utilize is 15 plus 5, 20 plus 20. How much? 40 GB. Sorry, 15 plus 5, 20 plus 10, 30 GB. Actual utilization is how much GB? 30 GB. Everybody agrees, my dear friend. Actual utilization is 30 GB. This server using 15 GB. This is using 5 GB and this is using 10 GB. Actual utilization is 30 GB. But how much space is blocked on the storage? These three machines are blocking how much GB? These three machines are blocking how much GB? 150 GB. But how much is used actually? 30 GB. Remember, my dear friend, if you want there should be no wastage of storage, then there is one concept which is known as thin disk. Thin disk. What is thin disk? Try to understand, my dear friend, what is the meaning of thin disk? You know, see over here. If I am having one ESX server, I am creating a virtual machine. I want to give 80 GB hard disk. But when I create an hard disk, it will say, do you want to create thin disk or you want to create thick disk? If I select thick, whatever 80 GB I have given, it will create VMDK file of 80 GB. This is VMDK file. If I select thick, but if I select thin, it will create one VMDK file of how much GB? You know, 0 KB. I will create a virtual machine. It will assign 80 GB. It will assign 80 GB. VMDK size can be maximum 80 GB, but it will create how much GB? You know, 0 KB file. Here, how much it will create? 80 GB file. Now, once virtual machine is created, if I start installing OS, then the size will of VMDK will increase. Consider after installing, it comes to 10 GB. It will not block complete 80 GB. Now, after installing OS, I will install one application. It will take 2 GB, so it will become 12 GB. If I put more data, it will become 14 GB, it will become 15 GB, it will keep on increasing. So remember, what is the concept of thin disk, my dear friend? What is the concept of thick disk? Whatever you assign 80 GB, it will block 80 GB. It will block 80 GB. And thin disk, what is the concept? If you give 80 GB, it will create a size of 0 KB. It will not block. If you put 10 GB data, it will become 10 GB. If you put 12 GB, it will put 12 GB. It can go maximum up to 80, but it will not block 80 if it is not using 80 GB. Are you getting the point? Means thin disk will increase. It will block space only if it is utilized. If it is not utilized by your operating system, it will not be blocked. So remember, my dear friend, if you go ahead over here and you give 50 GB, 20 GB, 80 GB. thin disks, if you give thin disks, then it will not block 150 GB. If it is using 15 GB, it will block 15 GB. 5 GB, 20 plus 10, 30. So total it will block 30 GB instead of 150 GB. So thin disks is beneficial, right? When thick disk is required, why thick disk is preferred? Everything we will discuss later on. Remember, today is just a very basic start. Remember, in thick disks also, na, there are two types of disks. Everything we will discuss in storage lecture. Don't worry. Okay, thick disks also, there are two types of disks. As of now, we are giving you a basic discussion about thin and thick. Okay, one guy is saying, if my virtual machine has been given 80 GB disks. Now, if it reaches 80 GB, what to do? Aray, my dear friend, if it reaches complete 80 GB, then you can do hot extend of hard disks. Okay, that practical also will do. By the way, as of now, just concentrate what is thin and what is thick. Okay, what is the difference between thin and thick? What are the types of thick disks? Thick disks also, there are two types. Okay, everything we will discuss later on. Now, my dear friend, please pay attention. One virtual machine, you create thick disks of 20 GB. If this virtual machine is using only 1 GB, then also it will block how much GB? 20 GB? Aray, because it is thick disk, na? Aray, virtual machine is using only 1 GB, then also it will log how much GB? 20 GB. But here you have created thin disk, here you have created thin disk. You have given 40 GB, you have given 80 GB, but it will not block 80 GB, it will not block 40 GB. Why? It is using 20 GB, it is using 40 GB. So total they will block how much GB? 60 GB. Plus it will block how much GB? 20 GB. So can you see? This is 20 GB and this is 60 GB. So total both are using 60 and this is 20. Why? This is not using, then also it is blocking, right? So it is 80 GB. Now out of 100 GB, 20 GB is free. Can you see out of 100, this is using 20, this is using 40, 60 plus this 20, 80, 100 GB, 20 GB is free. But consider if this is also thick disk, this is also thick disk, then 40 plus 80, 120 plus 20, 140 GB space required. Can I put three machine on 100 GB storage? Can I put 100 GB storage? No. But remember, if I am using thin disk, I can use 100 GB storage to put three machines. Are you getting the point, na? So my dear friend, it will drastically save on storage cost. If one virtual machine require 1 TB, you will give 1 TB, but it is using only 100 GB. So it will block only 100 GB on the storage. Data store. So remember, if you create a virtual machine with 1 TB, it will not block 1 TB space on your data store. VMDK file will not be a 1 TB. Why? It is using 100 GB, na? So the size of your VMDK will be only 100 GB. Getting the point? So remember, thin disk saves money, drastically save on your storage cost. Okay? So my dear friend, thin disk are best disks. 80-90% in the production people use thin disk. Why? It will provision storage only based on what is needed now, and you can grow over the time. So today it is using 40 GB, but tomorrow if it requires more 5 GB, it can go 5 GB, 5 GB, 5 GB, up to 80 GB it can go. Okay, now there is one question from Sachin Patil. Can we change thick to thin? Aray, my dear friend, there are medicines available. Those people who are fat cats, they can convert to slim, and those people who are slim, they can get converted to fat. Aray, do you agree with me, my dear friend? So many medicines are available in the market, Sachin Patil. Okay, so my dear friend, you can convert a thick disk to thin disk also, and you can convert a thin disk to thick disk also. So Nali has asked one question. If I have how to convert, we will discuss in storage lecture. Don't worry. If I have a requirement of 20 GB virtual machine and I select thin, means 0 KB is used, but 0 KB OS will not install, then how come VM will create and what is the remaining size will go? So Nali, my dear sister, you have not understood my explanation. Please pay attention. What I try to explain you, do you know? My dear sister, see what I am trying to say. You are having one ESX server. Okay. This is your data store hard disk of 100 GB. Now you create a virtual machine. When you create a virtual machine, you will just select OS, na? You will not install OS. Aray, do you agree, my dear friend? When you will create a virtual machine, you will select, I want 4 GB RAM, I want 12 core CPU, I want 100 GB hard disk, when you give 100 GB hard disk and you say finish na, your hard disk size will be 0 KB. But when you start installing OS na, your size will increase. If your OS is using 10 GB, then VMDK size will be 10 GB. Even if you have given 100 GB, it will not block 100 GB space on your storage. Getting the point, Sonali? Are you getting the point? Okay. So if thin storage reaches to provision storage, yes, Abhijit bhai, then what is the problem? If your disk, if this is getting full, or if your virtual machine you have given 80 GB and this complete 80 GB is full, then you can extend the hard disk. That live practicals we will do. That is known as hot extend practical. Okay. Sonali, you have understood the concept. That is a great deal that you are able to understand the concept. So my dear friends, hopefully everybody is now aware what is server virtualization, what is storage virtualization, what is network virtualization, what is the meaning of data store. Data store is nothing but the storage connect to your ESX host. What is the meaning of VMFS? VMFS is a file system. What is thin disk and what is thick disk? Okay, everybody has understood. This is nothing but the basics about what.
So my dear friends, at the end of this session, I would like to inform you that Attari Classes has multiple course offerings. You can, we have the course for AWS Cloud Solution Architect. We have the course for Azure Cloud Administration. And one of the leading companies in the world for virtualization is VMware. We provide training on VMware vSphere. And if you are looking for any server training on Windows, we have a Microsoft Server course, Windows Server course. And for networking, we have a CCNA course. So if you are looking for any of these courses, you can get in touch with our support desk on, you can get in touch with our support desk on this number, 9987088551. If you're calling outside India, you can add +91. Do remember that every session, every lecture, the first lecture of any new batch is a free demo lecture. So don't miss and try to attend a free live demo session at Attari Classes. Thank you.